Hi, I'm Jody Shelley, and welcome to Under Review, presented by Continental Office. And today we have Pierre-Luc Dubois. Thanks for being here.
No problem.
We got a lot of good highlights this year. So, Pierre-Luc, you are under review.
Hopefully it's good.
It'll be great. So we're going to start in overtime, 3-3 against the Los Angeles Kings. Here you are behind the net. All right, if we stop it here, what's going on? Why are you stopped?
I think Jonesy went to change, so I was just waiting for Z to come back, see what Z was going to do, maybe give me an option. Just read the plays.
Are you watching the defenders at all to see where they're at, or are you just kind of feeling it?
Yeah, now Z's coming in. Now they have 73s on me. Carter's swinging with Z, so then I'm see the space in the open in the center of the ice. I see Gus cutting across, so then I think it's my opportunity. I have kind of a window to jump through, the two defending players.
But it all started behind the net. So is it nerve-wracking three on three?
No, it's fun because, you can be patient, but at the same time, there's probably going to be a goal at some point in the 5 minutes. So every time you're out there, you can't just hope for next shift. You kind of have to, as soon as you see an opportunity, you got to take it because you don't know if the next shift might be a goal.
But it doesn't bother you. I know some guys would be nervous, like to have the puck. I don't want it. You take it.
Yeah, no, it's just like 5-on-5. It's fun.
It's fun. Except next goal wins.
Yeah, exactly. A little more pressure.
So yeah, this was a heck of a play. And you said Gus right here, and then hope he gets it to me. I can beat my guy.
Yeah, now I know I kind of beat him. So I was just hoping the puck was going to come just a little bit in front. And then once it's right there, then I just got to put it.
Nah, that's a good shot. That's a good shot.
I just got to put it over the goalie at that point.
Crossbody upstairs. Great job. This is against the Florida Panthers. Okay, you get down the wall, and now what do you see here? Because I don't see anything. You got a guy on you, you got a white jersey on the faceoff dot, you've got two defenders in front and one blue jersey.
I beat him here.
Yeah.
And then I take a quick look, just before getting to the puck. So I know that they're
Oh yeah, there's your look, yeah.
Yeah, I see that, Gerby's going to the net, so they're going to have a D on Gerby. Center's probably going to come on me at some point. He's not going to come too fast because he's going to want to read what side I'm going on, but he's going to come at some point. And then their winger, one winger is going to go to the wall because he might think that I might just throw it up the wall. And then the other winger, he's not going to come necessarily across like that because he doesn't know which side I'm going to go on either. She doesn't want to commit to one side. I just see Sten's in the perfect area.
You didn't see him until right there?
I see where their players are.
Yeah.
And I just hope that one of our players goes in, the space that I see that we can create. And then, like I said, Sens is in that perfect area. So as soon as I turn, my eyesight goes to where I think the open ice is.
Okay.
So it's all split decisions and it's all kind of experience. But like I said, I just see where the area could possibly be. And then after that, that's where my first look is to that area. And if there's no guy there, then I just got to move to plan B.
That's awesome. I mean, that is, you're right, it's experience, but those are all quick decisions, and then you're like, okay, I hope this is the open ice, and there's Stenlin. You're like, oh, there he is. Okay, you're in front of the net, right?
Yeah.
So they get a great opportunity. Now you're standing there.
Okay, so
are you playing defense?
Yeah, I had McAvoy the entire shift. We're just turning around. And then here I see Jonesy gets it. So I'm hoping, when he was in the corner, I was hoping, I thought maybe he might pass it across and jump through the middle for a 2-on-1.
So you're an option.
Yeah, so now I think when he starts skating up a bit, like here, he saw me, so I thought maybe he would maybe pass it, and then he decides to keep it and cut. So now I know now it's a 2-on-1. All I got to do is stay onside.
Yeah, that's not easy.
That's the hardest part of the goal.
And you did a great job there.
Yeah, so now I just got to keep my speed, maybe give him, I don't know if he's passing or shooting, but I got to give him a lane. I can't have my stick in the their defenseman's feet or something. I got to stay at, give him a passing lane.
Right, so right here you got a passing lane. You see McAvoy. So you could go a little too fast and Seth would have no passing lane. And that's probably what McAvoy is hoping, right?
Yeah, exactly. You want to be fast, but at the same time you don't want to be out of position. So I know Jonesy probably wants to pass it. He's a righty, So it's dangerous for their defenseman because he can shoot, he can pass. But, you have to find that passing lane. Jonesy makes a really nice pass. Same thing, I just got to put it over the goalie.
Is that in your wheelhouse or do you have to adjust a little bit?
No, that was a perfect pass.
Was it perfect?
Yeah, it was a perfect pass.
And a perfect shot. All right, let's see where you are here.
Okay, so yeah, now it's just like a kind of like a scramble in the corner, a bunch of guys around. Now pucks.
There you are.
Yeah, you got to put the body in front of his body first. Make him reach so then you can knock him off. And then I saw Robbie or Stenz. I wasn't sure who it was. I thought it was Stenz. That's why I kind of put it on Robbie's backhand a bit. But you just see colors you don't see necessarily. Sometimes you just see the color, you just see a body.
So right here, you're thinking, okay, it's Stenlin, who's a right-handed shot in the middle of the ice, but it's actually Robbie, who's a lefty.
Yeah.
So you're trying to put it to his right side because it's Stenlin.
Yeah, I tried to put it. I thought it was Stenlin who was there. My last read, the last time I saw a guy,
right.
I thought it was Stenlin. And then I saw their two guys come on me, so I thought Stenlin was going to be open. It was a bad position because it was a lefty. It was Robbie. I gave him on a backhand. But
still, that read is impressive because, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
If you can do your lineman, winger that favor and put it on that side, I mean, that's...
Yeah, exactly. Like if that's Stenlin who gets it instead of Robbie for the one-timer, that might be a goal.
Right. So you got to make those quick reads all the time.
Yeah, it's a lot, especially like in cycling. Like on the rush, from when you're skating from the red line to the blue line, you could pretty much see who's coming, who's coming on the next wave and stuff like that. But when you're in the corner and you're switching off guys, and when you have a righty and a lefty with you on your line, when you get to the corner and their D's on you and their second guy comes on you, when you have two guys on you, that you have a guy that's open.
Yeah.
You just got to find him where he is.
And which hand he is
now, yeah.
So you have, that's you, right, with the puck?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're driving in the corner.
Trying to get a little shot off there.
Okay, you kind of just fly out of there.
Yeah, tried on the rush, tried to get a little shot off. Then the puck bounced to the other side. So I'm trying to, right now I'm trying to reload a bit. I think that's, Bemmer gets a good stick on it, so I'm coming back to kind of support him. Puck pops out.
Stay above the puck?
Yeah, exactly. At first you're kind of out of position, but you're still in a position where your momentum is going to bring you back into position, back into the play. And then when you're coming back, F3, you can make a read when you're coming back across.
And this is a dream scenario. No one's paying attention to you, and you need little time to put that past Carey Price. Well, thanks for breaking it down with us. It was, it's fun to see what you think and how you do it. You make it look easy. And thanks for being under review.
Thank you.